In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to place icons on a web page. And icons, also known as glyphicons, iconography, they're small pictures that behave like fonts, and you sometimes see them used as buttons, hyperlinks, bullet points. They can be used for pretty much anything you want. And here on FontAwesome's homepage, you can see a few examples being used for links out to other pages, and then they're just kind of showing you some examples of some of the icons that are available here. Okay, so there's lots of services for this. I am going to be using FontAwesome, which gives you some access for free. All right, so as long as you're not going to be getting more than 10,000 page views per month, probably FontAwesome is going to work for you. Okay, so the first thing you're going to need to do is sign up for an account, and so we're either going to click on start for free here, or start, all right, doesn't really matter. And all you need to do is put in an email address and then click send the kit code. All right, then you're gonna have to go to that email and confirm it. And that kit code is basically an API key so they can keep track of, you know, how many page views you're using for that free account. All right, so I'll give you a minute to do that once you pause the video and then start it back up once you confirm your email address. Okay, so once you confirm, you're going to need to sign in. Okay, so once you're signed in, you may not be at this page. I got here by clicking on this kits link. All right, and here's that API key that I mentioned. All right, if we open it up, this is the code we're going to need to copy into a web page so that the web page can go out, or the browser can go out and get the icons that we want to use. All right, so they're going to be served directly from FontAwesome. I'm going to click copy, and then I am going to go ahead and start a web page. Okay, so I'll just go ahead and start my web page. All right, and then in the head section, I'm going to paste that link that I just copied from FontAwesome. And then in the body, we can start placing icons. All right, so I'm going to go back to FontAwesome, find some icon that we want. Okay, so I can either click icons, or I'm going to click search here. And then, you know, maybe I want something like Instagram. Okay, so you can see that, all right, we have free selected here. And okay, there are three Instagrams, and so I'm just going to click this one, and I'm going to copy this code. All I need to do is click inside this box, and it's copied, and then I'm going to paste this in the body of my HTML page. Okay, so now we have the Instagram icon, and we can kind of tell from the name here. Oh, what if I wanted to add Twitter? Well, I could probably just replace that with Twitter, and it would probably work. All right, we'll test it out in a minute. All right, let's just see what this looks like first. Okay, so there it is, pretty small up here in the corner, not very exciting, but yes, it looks like Instagram. Okay, and then, okay, what if we want to make that a hyperlink? Let's go and make that change. So I'll just wrap in the anchor tag here. All right, and then I will save and refresh. And okay, now when I hover over the icon, it lights up as a hyperlink. Let's go ahead and make it a little bit bigger and maybe change the color. Okay, so up here in the head section, I'm gonna add some style. Okay, and it's gonna be style on this FA Brands class. So that's .fa-brands. All right, and then maybe I want the size. All right, let's just try, say, 36 point. Okay, so that's what that looks like. All right, we can see that, okay, it's blue because it's a hyperlink. And then, okay, if I don't want it to be blue, I can change its color. And I can make it whatever I like. So I could put a hex code here, a red, green, blue value. All right, I'm just gonna type orange. Okay, now we have an orange hyperlink. All right, this one doesn't actually go anywhere. It just has a placeholder. And then, all right, let's try what I was saying before and add something like Twitter, YouTube, something like that. All right, so I'm gonna copy this. All right, I'm gonna paste right below it. All right, and then I'm just gonna change this and let's make it LinkedIn. All right, and then I'll save that and let's see if that works. And it does. All right, maybe you think they're a little squished together here, so we can add some space there. All right, and just notice that, yep, it has the same style because, all right, they all have this FA Brands class. If I want to add a space, I can use this non-breaking white space. Okay, so a little bit of space there. If you want a second space, right, we'll just have to copy and paste. All right, and let's put in one more link. And actually, I'll make this one live. So I'll go to HTTPS. All right, and then my username. Okay, and then let's try YouTube. All right, and then, okay, we might as well add Twitter. And don't need these on the last one. Put them up on the second one. If I want, yep, I can make these live. And okay, so there's our links. If I click, takes me out to Twitter and my stream here. Okay, what if we want them, instead of appearing all on one line, what if we want them to appear each on their own line? There's a couple of ways I could do this. Probably the easiest way is going to be to put them inside paragraphs. Okay, so just start typing a P there. All right, and then move the closing tag. All right, and then I'll just kind of repeat the process. Okay, let's see what that looks like. Okay, so each on their own line, a little unevenly spaced here. All right, so we'll see if we can fix that. All right, I don't need these non-breaking spaces anymore. All right, and then I'll add some style to the paragraph to kind of see if I can control how this stuff is displayed. I can do something like tell it that it should not have any margin. Okay, so a little better there. You know, if they're spaced too closely, right, we'll give it a little bit of margin, right, maybe 5 pixels. And then if you don't want them aligned on the left here, we can align them on the right. Okay, so hopefully that helps you get started with placing icons using FontAwesome.